Phil Dale from Skarnsundet Fjord Centre, and today we've come down to fish a relatively new mark for us at Skarnsundet called Joe's Hole. I'm just getting a bite. Bit of a strange name, I know. Joe Arch got to name it because he had a double shot of Plaice from here. Fantastic mark. Lies about a kilometre outside of Straumen, inside Bergen. Inside Bergen Fjord. Fishing between, obviously, the land and an island. About a 300-yard gap. And it's sand. It's sand all the way through. Little patches of kelp and rock here and there, but nothing to be too worried about. Fantastic place, Mark. This is really why we come here. It's predominantly to target cliff. Get plenty of cods and dabs as well. I'm sorry, I've got something else around this here. Plenty of cods and dabs as well, but a really easy, interesting mark to fish. That's a nice fish on here. Nice and easy mark to fish. Not a lot of snags, and any ability of angler can catch fish here. Big Jay, Jason White, he's just had a £4.4 place here. There doesn't seem to be any small place here. I don't think there's many place under £2 being caught from this mark. But I say it's a relatively new mark for us, so we're just exploring the potential, really. Jay had his place on a pulley wishbone rig, green and black bait, and ragworm. It's always the dominant bait for place. This seems like a tidy fish I've got on here now. Fishing about 80 yards out. Nice run of current as well. Nice and steady, not too much. We've seen most of our best results have been on the ebb. We got here just after high water, fishing the first of the ebb, and Jay was straight into his place straight away. But with it being such a new mark, we're still relatively trying to explore it, find out exactly when it fishes, so we can relay that information back to our guests. I'll just wind this fish in. Doesn't feel like a monster. Just flicking down tide a little bit now. I'm fishing braid, you see, on a Ziplex Norway edition rod. Fantastic rod. 14 foot long, two equal sections. Unlimited distance and great for Norway. Can handle anything Norway throws at it, really. And that's it, it's quite nice for place fishing as well. It's nice to have a rod like that with that versatility. I'll just get this in, I can have a quick look at it. It wasn't really planned like this, but... there's a cod on it, on one hook. I was hoping to see... place on the other. Oh, just a crop. That's quite pretty much the standard of the cod we get off this mark. Quite a few doubles the last few times we've fished it. They're all in pristine condition. Nice codling. Again on a rag bait. I'll just get him slipped back. If you come into Skarnsundet, I'll bring you down and I'll show you this mark, and I think you're going to have a lot of enjoyment. You're going to catch a lot of nice cod, dabs between £1, £2, and I really have no idea how big the plaice are in here. I think there's a good chance of a double bigger plaice from this type of mark, but time will tell. Great.
Okay.
4.3 was it?
Yeah, £4.3.
Big J's just going to release a £4.3 plaice. This is what we want to see at Skarnsundet. Catch and release. Look at that. Full of roe, so it's very, very important that these fish go back.
Look at that.
Look at that. That is absolutely beautiful.
and let him rest there for a bit. Fantastic. Big Jay just reeled in another nice place in a codling. From Joe's Hall. It's the second one he's had today. First one was 4-4. This looks a bit over 2 pound fish, maybe a bit bigger. 2.10.
Nice place.
Lovely. Rag tipped with white.
On again on the green and black beads. And the codling on the other wishbone.
Fantastic. Well done, Jay.
Cheers. Thank you, Phil.
So this is the rig you caught your 4 pound 4 place on then, Jay?
Yep, it's quite a simple rig, Phil. I'll go from the weight end first. 7 ounce weight.
Yep.
Clear impact shield. I personally prefer clear impact shields. It's just my preference.
Yeah.
Clear water. I just like to keep it
confidence.
Nice and, yeah, nice and simple. So what I've done, put it at the bottom. Nice little stop knot to stop it from sliding right the way up the pulley.
Yeah.
100 pound rig body.
Yeah.
Keeps it nice and stiff on the seabed. Safety reasons as well, as we discussed earlier when fishing close together.
Yeah, cast in, yeah.
Yeah, about a metre long, which yeah. I always keep my traces, I measure them and cut them to the same length. They're always a metre long or thereabouts,
right.
But that is a metre.
Yeah.
Right, now, swivel, 120 pound coxswain rule swivel.
Yeah. Strong.
Very strong.
Reliable.
Yeah, stainless steel, very good. Best components, because you know you're only here a couple of weeks, a year if you're lucky.
And if you hook that 10 pound place, Jay, you'll want to be landing it, right?
Yeah, you don't want to see it swim off with a snood in its mouth. 40 pound snood line.
Yeah.
Again, that keeps that nice and stiff when it's on the seabed.
Yeah.
Right, business end.
Right, what are we looking at?
Now this is like a pulley wishbone, I call it. Yeah.
Right,
it's a pulley rig, but I've got a moving wishbone.
Yeah.
On the business end.
This is a very similar rig. I had my 7 pound 7 place on that. I don't know whether you've heard about, but I had a 7 pound 7.
No, that's news to me.
Really?
Yeah.
But very similar setup. But I used it as an up and over.
Okay.
But you're using a pulley style, so that's nice to.
Well,
nice
I like
to
this
see.
Because that's sitting on the seabed.
Yeah.
If a fish comes along and takes that bait, it's got a small amount of movement for confidence,
yeah.
And then it sets the hook.
Yeah.
And if then you get another fish is moving on that hook, it's moving that bait.
Right, yeah.
So again, it's more attraction.
Yeah.
But what I've done here, the day before yesterday I fished here and I just used ordinary snood trace line.
Yeah.
But today I've tied up this rig with fluorocarbon. I just feel a lot more confident using fluorocarbon.
You hear a lot of people going over onto that fluorocarbon because I think it gives people the confidence.
Yes, they say it's translucent in the water. It's a good quality fluorocarbon.
Whether it is or not, it gives you confidence, doesn't it?
Yeah.
And for me, confidence in my bait and my gear is probably the thing that catches the most fish for me.
And to be honest with you, when you've got confidence, everything seems to just fall into place, and it's hard to explain, but when I'm fishing best is when I've got my best bait, my best rig, and
you're already catching fish in your head, aren't you?
That's
it. You know, because you know the
gear, and
I'm
switched on.
If you're an angler that just goes and doesn't think about these types of things, I don't think that angler has that confidence that you get from that quality bait, quality components, and confidence in what you're using.
And, you know, I'm here, you know, once, maybe twice a year if I'm lucky. I want to make the most of this period because this is such a special place. Now, as we all know, Plaice love green and black beads.
Seems to do.
Yeah, these are 5mm green and black beads.
Yeah, nice and glowy, them ones.
Yeah, coxswain rule, lovely hook, lovely
beads.
Yeah,
they seem to be a bit more glowy than the other ones, don't they?
Two coxswain rule 1.0 hooks. Now, we know the reason black and green is light for Plaice because they think it looks like pea mussel.
Yeah.
So, again, that's why I've gone with it. So, what I'm going to do now is I'll bait it up.
Bait it up.
Now, I've got some lovely ragworm here.
That's nice.
Which I'll start with this one. Through the head.
Head hooked.
Yeah, head hooked. I have been just head hooking and leaving the tails dangling for a movement, but I've found that it's being nailed more by the cod and other species, dabs. So I'm putting the worm almost right the way up the hook. So that's the first one. Now this one, I'm going to chunk a worm, take the meaty part of this lovely ragworm, She'll now take that. So the head and the muscle is just above the hook.
Yeah.
And I'll take that off there. Now some people like to whip the ragworm on.
Right. Okay.
But because it's such a large worm,
yeah,
it's pretty much holding itself.
Yeah.
So I've just moved that up the slough like so.
And would you tip that off with something?
Yeah, well, we've got some lovely whites here.
Oh, nice.
So, one about this size.
Yeah.
And I tend just to go through the side like so. People do it how they want to do it, but this is what works for me.
Just again, maybe confidence.
Yeah. Just work that up the hook, and there you go.
Look
so we've
at
got
that.
Two lovely baits there.
That looks perfect, yeah, doesn't it?
And then, to top that off, get my fingers around it, top that off, and then put it up behind the impact shield.
Yeah.
And there you have it.
That nice, nice castable bait as well.
Yep.
Close together.
Yep.
And then it's going to sit there and present well when it hits.
Now, if you want to, before you cast that, just dip it into the fjord. It basically makes the bait tense up, and obviously when it hits the water, the impact shield will break the surface tension and help protect the bait as it makes its way to the seabed.
Lovely, Richard. And it's caught you two plays today, and your personal best.
Yeah, £4.4.
Fantastic.
Over the moon, mate.
Let's get it out there. Lovely.
Cheers, mate.
Thank you. Well, we've had a fantastic day down here on in Joe's Hole. Big J's had two plays, personal best, £4.4, another round about 2.10. We've had a stack load of cod, plenty of dabs between £1, £1.50, and it's been a really enjoyable day's fishing. Sun's shining, feels like summer's coming, Plaice are biting, and it's brilliant. When you come into Skarnsundet, have a word with me, and I'll run you down and I'll show you this mark, where to fish, what to look out for, and give you as much help as possible. Look forward to seeing you.